Hello and welcome to WLtoys channel. In this video, I'm gonna show you how to use a multi-protocol module with car transmitter, specifically with Radiolink. Before we begin, I'd like to thank the people from rcgroups.com for helping me setting up this module. Now let's get started. The multi-protocol module I use is iRangeX IRX 4+. It supports many protocols, and what I want to use are mainly FlySky AFHDS and WLtoys V2X2. You might need to program it, so I'll have all the links for tutorial and documentation about how to burn the bootloader and setting up the Arduino IDE in the description below. However, it is not necessary if your radio has 4 or more channels and you use the protocol that doesn't need any configuration, for example, the FlySky AFHDS. But if you are confused by the documentation, please comment below, let me know and I'll make another tutorial video focusing on how to set up this particular module. To use the module with car transmitter, we use it in PPM mode, so it only needs 3 wires, which are PPM signal, power from 5 to 14 volt, and ground. This will work with pretty much any transmitter that has PPM output, or DSC or trainer port like this. I choose to try this with Radiolink first, because it has DSC port and it is easy to mod. Also, it has 4 channels, which are needed when using with MiniZ. My ultimate goal is to use this module with Futaba 3PK. All you have to do on the transmitter is making a plug to connect it to the module. Here's how you do it on Radiolink. Starting by disassembling it. First, pull the VR knob and the switch out. Remove the sticker at the front. And then remove all the screws. Inside, you can remove the board. Then unscrew the screen out so it is easier to solder. You can check which of the DSC terminals output PPM signal by using multimeter. The PPM will output about 2.7 volt. I'll use the power directly from the switch, so when I turn the transmitter on, the module will be turned on too. Here are 3 spots you'll have to solder the wires in too. This one is for PPM signal. This one is for power. And this one is for ground. Now you can attach these wires into pins like this. PPM on the top. Skip the next pin. Then power. And ground. And it is ready to plug into the module with PPM pin at the top. Finally, I attach the module to the transmitter with double-sided tape. You can build the module into the transmitter if you like. Next, you can make some modification to the firmware to make it work better. You can skip this part if you want. For now, I want to make it use only the channels that the radio can provide, so I can reduce a bit of latency. However, some car like WLtoys will need a bit of configuration to work, which I'll come back to it later. Once you open up the Arduino IDE, open up the multiprotocol project by opening up the multiprotocol.ino file. Now, select the underscore config.h. and change the min channel to 3 and max channel to 4. Because Radiolink has 4 channels, and later I'll use this module with other transmitter that has 3 channels. As for the endpoint setting, I'll modify the min and max pulse, so it will output all the available pulse, and I can have a bit of extra steering too. Use double slash to comment out the default setting, and delete them to uncomment the TX custom. Then go down a bit and modify the values. I've checked the Radiolink output, and the range is between 1000 and 1985, so replace the values with the ones I've just set. You can also change the protocol selection order by swapping the lines here. Each one represents the knob position on the module. I change the order to make FlySky AFHDS number 1 and V2X2 number 2, so I can choose what I frequently use easier. Once finished, choose the board, upload method, and the port where the module is connected to. Then verify and upload the modified firmware. That's it for now. Next, I'll show you how to buy and set up the transmitter for MiniZ Sports with KT19 transmitter, MiniQ, and WLtoys. I have the timestamp below, so you can skip to see the car you want. For MiniZ, you need a transmitter with 4 channels. That's why I use Radiolink. There's a way to program the output too, but I haven't tried it yet. So for now, let's stick with the 4 channels radio. Select FlySky AFHDS protocol on the module. Now hold the buy button on the car and turn it on. Then hold the buy button on the module and turn the transmitter on. When the green light comes on, release the buy button. You'll see the light on the car stop blinking, which means the binding is complete. Now turn the car off and on again to drive. On the transmitter, you have to reverse 3 channels, steering to turn correctly. Throttle so it goes forward, brake and reverse. And channel 4 to have full steering. Finally, set the steering EPA to make it turn left and right equally. For MiniQ, use FlySky AFHDS protocol. Hold the buy button on the car and turn it on. Now hold the buy button on the module and turn the transmitter on. When the green light comes on, you can let go of the button. Now you'll see the light on the car is blinking slowly, which means the binding is complete. Wait a bit for the light on the car to go solid, then you can drive it. On the transmitter, you'll have to check if the car turns left and right, and go forward, brake, reverse correctly, because it's different from car to car. If the steering is wrong, reverse the steering channel or channel 1. If the car doesn't go forward, brake, reverse, you have to reverse the throttle. Finally, set the steering EPA to make it turn left and right equally. For WLtoys, the channel order is different. You have two options of doing this. First, by using the channel mixing on your transmitter if you have it. The other way is to configure it from the firmware, which I consider to be better. Go to Arduino IDE and open up the Multiprotocol. Select the V2X2. Go down to Send Packet. Look at the else. You have to change the order from 0, 1, 2, 3 to 0, 3, 2, 1. Now verify and upload it to the module. Once finished, disconnect it from the computer and select the V2X2 protocol on the module. I have changed it to position 2 on mine, yours might be different. Now turn the car on. The LED will blink. Then hold the buy button on the module and turn the transmitter on. When the green light comes on, release the buy button. Wait for a bit and you'll see the light on the car go solid. Now you can drive it. On the transmitter, you have to reverse only the steering. Normally, the throttle should work without reversing the channel. Well, at least my car does. What you need to check is throttle trim. It should go from forward to brake and reverse smoothly. And when the trigger is at the center, the car shouldn't have buzzing sound. Adjust the trim until the buzzing stops. Finally, set the steering EPA to make it turn left and right equally. There you have it. Now you can use your favorite transmitter with pretty much any car that this module supports. And that's it for this video. Please subscribe if you want to see more content like this and press the bell icon to get notification whenever I upload a new video. You can follow me on Facebook to see what I'm doing between videos along with some quick updates. Thanks for watching and see you again next time.